Welcome to Earl Stewart on Cars.
As far as this game, the negotiation process, so the salesperson is the pawn, and he wants to identify with the customer as the customer's friend. It's almost like a good cop, bad cop kind of thing that you see on television. So the salesperson wants to become your friend, and he wants you to commit to a price. So the old school psychology says that if you can get the customer to commit to a price, then you've made a movement to sell him a car when he commits, even if it's a low figure. So you always ask him to make an offer on the car. You're not supposed to give the customer a price. You're supposed to ask the customer for a price. So the customer will come up with a very low price. Now, you know it's well below your cost. So you say, excuse me, because you want, remember, you're the salesman. You want to be the customer's friend. Let me take that to my manager. So that you leave the customer in the closing office. You know, that's the closing booth, they call them. And they walk out of that office area, and they walk into another office area, maybe around the corner where you can't even see them. And then what are they doing in the office? They're either smoking cigarettes or drinking coffee or telling dirty jokes. They're not talking about the deal. They're making you wait because they want the customer to think that you're working real hard. Now, you're the salesman. You're the customer's good friend, remember? And you're dealing against the bad cop, the sales manager, and you're doing your best. You're begging him to sell this customer the car at that unrealistically low price. So after they've had a couple cigarettes and a couple cups of coffee, then they pencil the deal. This is called penciling the deal. So they put a big X through the price that the customer offered on the vehicle buyer's order, and then they write another number, which is way over the profit that you would expect to make. And that's the way the game goes. So back and forth, slowly the customer comes up a little bit, and then the sales manager comes down, he's penciling the deal. And at some point, the customer gives in, you wear him down. The sales manager might just say, no, we can't sell your car at that price. And when that happens, by the way, that's usually just part of the whole game because they want you to believe that they're very serious. When you say, I'm sorry, we can't make a deal, that might mean maybe we can get them to come up to our price. And they'll let it go sometimes all the way to letting the husband and wife get up and walk all the way out to the car. I've heard cases where they actually let them get in the car and the salesman will go running and chasing, wait a minute. And they pull over and they come back in and they play this game. It's humorous if it wasn't so inconvenient and angering to the average car buyer. And the average car buyer, they're going to retailers that are treating them with courtesy and respect and integrity, and then they come into a car dealership, it's like they've fallen back in time. They're in Sodom and Gomorrah, and it's a terrible, terrible situation. What do you do about it? You just refuse to play the game. The best thing you can do is you go into the dealership and you say, I want you to give me a price. I want you to give me your best price, and you can either give me that best price or I will leave here and I will never come back again. There's four Chevrolet dealers in this area, in this market, and I'm going to buy a Chevrolet Camaro, and this is a description, and this is the MSRP and the accessories I want. Give me your best price, and I am going to take that best price, and I'm going to compare it. If it's close, I might even come back and give you a second chance, but if you don't give me a price, you'll never see me again. You have to take control. You have to take the control away from the salesman, away from the sales manager. You're the consumer. You have the money. You have a tremendous amount of power. And by exercising that control, you can defeat this archaic system that's being used even today in the car business.